part of their power to choose their government. It is a rare opportunity to choose your government. Why should you give up that choice? You have to, actually you have to even go to vote, because some people are talking about a boycott. I think that's wrong, because we have an opportunity to choose our government, to make our government. If we boycott, we will give others the power to choose our government. Others will choose our government, and that we don't want. Some people say that all candidates are bad, so we should not vote. I say no, because some are more bad than others. You go and choose the least bad person. That way you have a say in your government, in the formation of your government. Unfortunate, but that's people's democratic right to contest. We cannot stop that. I know that some of them are proxy candidates. That is, they are there in some way to either support a candidate or to make a candidate lose. But that's democracy. We cannot do much about it. There is also the provision in the Presidential Act for each candidate to be given 45 minutes free time on TV. And some of these people are there to make use of the time to advance. By himself, their candidate might have 45 minutes. But with four proxies, he would have five times 45 minutes. Likewise on radio. There's a misuse of resources, but it's their democratic right. We cannot stop that. But the rule is that you cannot be a candidate and ask for people to vote for another person. But you can say, don't vote for such and such a person. So that way they will have to use their proxy status also carefully. Otherwise, we won't give them that 45 minutes. They are not to say, vote for someone else. 26 inches long or 27 inches long. The voting booth is like an upside down cardboard box. And sometimes if it's a long ballot paper, if you go and write, some of the part of the ballot paper will stick out. So in some ways, confidentiality can be lost. Others can see how you voted, at least for the last few. If they are blank, they know you didn't vote for those people. Says that we have to accommodate all 35 candidates. So the ballot paper is long. As a result, the traditional teak ballot box we have been using is not large enough to fit so many papers. So we have had to change ballot boxes. Making new larger teak boxes would be costly. So we are making do with plastic ballot boxes and cardboard ballot boxes. And because the law says that the ballot box must have a lock, we are placing locks for cardboard boxes. But this whole election management system is about sticking to the law. If we don't stick to the law, someone will challenge the election, saying that it's in violation of the law and therefore the result should be annulled. The ballot paper is a long paper, 26 inches long. It has 35 rows with lines in between. And in each row, the first is a long box, maybe 4 inches long. That has the name of the candidate in Sinhalese, Tamil, and then thirdly the name of the candidate in English. And then the next box contains the party symbol of the candidate. There is nowhere for the name of the party to appear. And then the last empty boxes where you mark 1, 2, 3. 1 or 2 or 3, or you can mark only 1, or you can mark 1 or 2, and it was today that we discussed and agreed you can even mark 1 and 3 without a 2. That is because the way we count, there is no difference between 2 and 3. If you interchange, 1 is very important, but if you interchange 2 and 3, the way they are treated is exactly the same. So even 3 we will accept. If you don't put 2 and put only 3, that would be accepted. Then of course the counting starts, and we are not allowed, unfortunately, to show you a sample, because the law explicitly says that it's confidential, because someone can try to print that ballot paper. Second ballot happens when there is 50%, there isn't 50% plus one vote for one person. could be critical in determining who the winner is ultimately, if there is a second count. These three are acceptable ways of marking it. The X means your intention is to vote for this as first preference, so it will be counted as your first preference. This is only your first preference, so it is accepted. This is 1, 2, 3, the perfect ballot, your first choice, second choice and third choice. These three are rejected. Here, because you have, instead of 1 or X, you have signed your name. That means you have identified yourself. Any mark that identifies who you are will be rejected. This is rejected because there is no 1. So there is, this is rejected because, again, it's not clear. This can be allowed to be 2 or 3, but if we take it as a 1, there is a conflict. So that's also rejected. And the identification, permitted identification forms at the election would be acceptable identification, your national identity card, valid driver's license, valid passport, and then an elderly person's identity card, a priest's or bhikkhu's identity card, or a retired person's pensioner's identity card. If you don't have any of these, you can still vote by going to the Grama Sevaka or Grama Niladari, and he or she will fill out a special identity card for you, voter's identity card. She will require a photograph, and she needs or he needs to know who you are. Or get yourself identified by someone from that village or your householder, and then with that special identity card you can go and vote. I don't know, but we have asked for a budget of 4 billion. I think it's about 150,000 people more. We are supposed to be successful, and I believe you can never be 100% successful. Election Commission's responsibilities are first are to conduct a free and fair election. With that comes the responsibility of doing the voter registration, which we have done, I think, satisfactorily. Then we have to conduct the election and count the votes and announce the result. These are our main thing. So in between elections, we do voter registration. And then, like any organization, we have organizational work, maintenance of buildings, planning for the future, planning for a better election next time, analyzing old elections. But the primary things are voter registration and conduct of the election. Go think carefully, think always. So my advice to voters is think, rise above identity and vote for the best candidate. If you think all are bad, don't boycott the elections, go and vote for the least bad candidate. Democratically, that's impossible. Who is to decide that? I mean, no one should take a decision like that. The people must have the right to return the person they want. If you and I think, you and I might think that someone is bad and shouldn't be a candidate, but there'll be more people thinking that he's good and should be a candidate. And right now, the situation is like that. If some of us are given a choice, we will ban certain candidates, because their background is bad. But no one has the authority to do that. No one. In a democracy, one man, one vote. We are all equal.